The Mets were able to get out of Dodge with a victory over the champs thanks to a strong effort from Marcus Stroman and the return of Javi Baez sparking the offense. We're now joined by former Mets general manager Omar MInaya. Omar, we saw how Baez was a catalyst on Sunday. How much could a 1-2 punch of Baez and Lindor ignite the Mets?
I think it's a lot. I really feel a lot. And I say this not only because these guys are good players and they're energetic players. They bring energy. They bring speed. I think there's something that when you are the way the team has played this year, you want a guy that's a catalyst, a guy that's going to take the extra base. You saw yesterday with Baez taking that extra base. It's really a single, but he made it into a double. And then you have Lindor, who's also energetic. To me, this is, I think, what's needed. I think we saw yesterday the spark that's needed. That energy goes on, transferred to other guys. And I expect that. These two guys together, and then you get Nimmo, who's as athletic also. But these two are the catalysts. They lead by their energy. And I think 1-2 together, which is what the plan was during the trading deadline. That's why I think everybody in baseball agreed that was a very good deal. But you got to have these guys in the lineup. You got to have in the lineup. And there's no doubt about it that Baez, the way he's played, the way he plays the game, it energizes everybody else. Like we've seen it over the years with Jose Reyes, how David Wright played. That's what you want to, what we bought in the trading deadline. And I think those two guys are going to be able to bring that to the table, and then which will mean we'll score more runs.
Creating energy and putting pressure on the defense definitely needed, because the inability to hit with men in scoring position has been an issue all year long for the Mets. Omar, at this point, do you think it's in the players' heads?
I think it has to be in the players' head. When you look at the numbers, and listen, it's just not only the numbers. When you look at the game, you watch the guys, and this really is a lot of it is frustration. Sometimes maybe a lot of guys trying to do too much. So, yes, it's in their head. But I can tell you one thing about this game is all it takes one or two guys, and all it takes could be a game like Sunday, you know, where guys say, okay, you know, you saw J.D. Davis taking the ball to right field. When guys, it's in their head, they're trying to do too much, they're trying to pull the ball too much, or sometimes they're just trying to look for the perfect pitch. And when you're in those situations, especially the way pitching is today, you know, when that you get that good fastball, you got to attack it. I think what we've seen a lot this year, and I think Louie talked about it, is that a lot of the guys have been in between. I see it as an evaluator, as a talent evaluator. I see guys taking pitches that you say, oh, man, even if they take them or even if they foul them off, they just need to be more aggressive. And we call it as, you know, you got to start selling out. And I think we've seen that, but guys can still change it up. But one or two guys leading the way can that domino effect to everybody else.
There's certainly a few guys to pick from for those one or two guys. And you mentioned being a talent evaluator. So as an executive, when you're trying to assess your own ball club, how do you balance an off year with what a player has done throughout his career?
Well, I'm a big believer that you just don't take a look at 1 year. You don't take a look at 1 month. I think you take a look at the body of work, especially major league players. So, you know, guys like Conforto, you know, those kind of guys, there's a body of work that has been done already. Yes, you do want to say, look, when I say a year, look, a lot of it has to do with, you know, bat speed as far as all the ball jumping off the bat, those kind of things. But guys will have that year, but I'm not going to be one to make an evaluation on 1 year on a player. I like to see a whole body of work, unless there's an injury and all those kind of things. It's about the volume, not just the recent performance for me when I make evaluation.
Mets certainly need to get some work done during this homestand, and it starts on Tuesday against the Giants. Omar MInaya, thanks for joining us here on Geico Sports Night.